بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد أنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام when referring to themselves قال إني عبد الله I am the servant of Allah سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده Allah called the Nabi of Allah Abd. So firstly, we have to realize we are the slaves of Allah. We belong to Allah. And everything else belongs to Allah. Inna Allah ashtara min al-mu'minina anfusahum wa amwalahum bi anna lahum al-jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bought from the people of Iman their lives and their wealth in exchange for Jannah. Means everything we own also belongs to Allah. Since we belong to Allah, our belongings belong to Allah, we should be dedicating all our time for Allah. But because the zahir, the outward shows, and it seems that I own this, is my possession, I worked for it. This insan gets pride, this person gets arrogance. He gets the quality of uluhiyat. He thinks of what he's doing, but he's not doing anything at all. He has no control. That's why in different ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows the helplessness of man. Inna alladhina tad'una min dunillah. لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا ذُبَابًا وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا لَهُ If all of mankind, all technology, all scientists, all doctors get together and decide that they want to create a fly, لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا It is impossible. It will never happen. You think so you have power and you want to cause the sun to rise or stop, then you can't do that. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides that the night will remain till Qiyamah and the sun will not rise, مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِضِيَاءٍ Who will bring to you this light? إِنْ جَعْلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ النَّهَارَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ But Allah decides that the sun will not set, daylight will remain forever. مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهُ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِلَيْلٍ تَسْكُنُونَ فِيهِ Which deity, which ilah, which god will bring you the night. فَلَمْ تَقْتُلُوهُمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ قَتَلَهُمْ When it was with regards to conquest, when with regards to battles, when with regards to anything, Allah said, you never did anything. وَمَا رَمَيْتَ إِذْ رَمَيْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ رَمَى O my beloved Nabi, it is I who did it. You have no power. All power belongs to Allah. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَصْبَحَ مَاءُكُمْ غَوْرًا If Allah decides that all the waters of the earth have to disappear, what will you do? فَمَنْ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِمَاءٍ مَعِينٍ Who will bring you that water back? Which power, which God, which ilah will bring you that water? One person, a philosopher, thought and he read this ayat and he said, I'll dig a borehole and I'll get water from under the earth. Because if the water recesses into the depths of the earth, there are streams flowing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed the water of his eye. He became blind. فَمَنْ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِمَاءٍ مَعِينٍ. Now let's see who will bring that water back into your eyes so you can have vision. يَا مَعْشَرَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. Let's challenge in all of you. O jinnat, get together. O insan, get together. إِنْ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ أَنْ تَنْفُذُوا مِنْ أَقْطَارِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Can you traverse the zones, the heavens and the earth? Can you surpass these confines? لَا تَنْفُذُونَ إِلَّا بِسُلْطَانِ. Without the power and the permission of Allah, you cannot do nothing. I belong to Allah. Everything I see belongs to Allah. Everything that moves belongs to Allah. Everything that stays stagnant belongs to Allah. That's why we need to be making this effort, establishing the greatness of Allah and negating غير الله. The asbab yaqini, what we're sure about, is Allah and the system of Allah. And غير yaqini is everything besides that. There's nothing sure. There's nothing definite about that. And man in history, Allah has taught us, every nation, when their attention went to asbab-e ghayr yaqini, then the yaqeen became strong in that, and it was the cause of their destruction. Somebody says wealth will do. Qarun said, wealth does. إِنَّمَا أُوْتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. It is my intelligence, my intellect that has got me who I am. And what wealth did he have? Allah says, we gave it to him. To tell us, وَآتَيْنَاهُ. I gave it to him. مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ. Such treasures that the keys لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُزْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ. You needed a team of warriors, a team of soldiers, a team of bodybuilders to carry the keys of his treasure. His yaqeen went to his wealth. That was the cause of his downfall. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. We not only sank him, but all his treasures also we sank him. If it was about your status, then Firaun said, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْعَالَىٰ. I have reached the highest status. I am God, I am Ilah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala drowned Firaun and wiped him out. If you think you have armies and weapons and mallet and artillery and numbers, then أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ. Didn't you see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did with the people of the elephant? أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَضْلِيلٍ. Allah wiped out all the planning. Allah sent the Ababil. What a small creation of Allah. And what a big army you are with elephants. To teach us, no matter how big you are, Allah doesn't need to use big force. Such small pebbles, stones. فَجْعَلَهُمْ كَأَسْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ. They were wiped out. If you think so, it is your trade and your business and your agricultural techniques. لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَأٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ جَنَّتَانِ أَنْ يَمِينِ وَشِمَالِ. They had gardens and gardens and gardens. The place of Sabah, the Mufassirin explained, was a business center at the time. And they were good at trade. Most of the gold mines of the Arab countries were located in Sabah. And they had constructed over 100 dams to contain the water and irrigate the fields around Yemen. And the dams were constructed such that it would suffice for the needs of the different seasons. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah explains that their gardens were so lush and flush that a woman would walk through the gardens with a basket on her head. She would not have to touch any tree, yet her basket would be filled with the juice dropping down from the fruit. That's their expertise. And they thought so, that that's the cause of their success. فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَيْلَ الْأَرِمِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that we wiped them out. ذَلِكَ جَزَيْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَفَرُوا And this was a recompense for what ingratitude they showed to Allah. If it is the strength that you think, then the people of Ad and Thamud. Ad said, Man ashadu minna quwwah. Who is stronger than us? Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi'ad. You not see how Allah wiped out these people who declared their strength? Fa'uhliku birihin sarsarin atiyah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a wind that wiped them out. وثمود الذين جابوا الصخر بالواد. Thamud, they used to carve their houses out of mountains. أولم يعلم أن الله قد أهلك. Don't they know? Don't they see? That Allah wiped out previous nations. Man huwa ashaddu minhu quwwah. Those that had more might, more power, wa akthar jamma. They had more numbers, they had more of everything. Allah taught every nation that your yaqeen shouldn't go to your creation, but should go to your creator. So our yaqeen is, if I make effort, the more I strive, I will get wealth, the more I get wealth, the more I can buy things, the more things I buy, the more my problems will be solved. But a person who makes effort doesn't mean he'll get things. An ice cream seller works the whole day in hot sun for 12, 16 hours, he gets 10 rand, $5. A person in his air-conditioned office makes one phone call, he makes $1 million. You have wealth, you can buy things. Things will give you happiness. A person has all the wealth in the world, he manufactures the best mattresses in the world, we tell you must be sleeping well, very well. He bought $1 million mattress, he says, no, I can't sleep. If you take tablets, I'm suffering from insomnia. Somebody owns the best chocolate factory in the world. We tell him, you must be enjoying the delicious chocolates. He says, sorry, I can't. I'm suffering from diabetes. So effort doesn't give you wealth. And wealth cannot get you things. And things cannot give you results. What yaqeen is if I make effort on Allah and the deen of Allah, then these amal, if Allah is happy with me, conditions will be good. When conditions are good, hayatan tayyiba, then on the earth conditions will be good. Otherwise, وَكَذَلِكَ نُوَلِّي بَعْدَ الظَّالِمِينَ بَعْضًا We are oppressors. We oppress in the deen of Allah. Allah puts bigger oppressors on us. So with us, we need to establish and negate Allah. Speak about the greatness of Allah so much that his heart accepts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the dua. We don't get affected by conditions in halat. Somebody came to one buzruk and told him, your ships are lost at sea. He looked down and said, Alhamdulillah. Somebody came back again and said, that was a rumor. It was not your ships. It was somebody else's ships. How many containers have been lost at sea? Your entire production has been lost. Now it's no more lost. He looked down and he said, Alhamdulillah. People that were around him said, Shaykh, we've seen something strange today. He said, Alhamdulillah, on both conditions. What's the wisdom? He said, when I was told it was lost, I checked my heart to see if my heart gets affected or not. And I said, Alhamdulillah, on the loss, it never got affected. And when I found out that it was not mine, I said, Alhamdulillah, because I never got happy. لِكَيْ لَا تَفْرَحُوا بِمَا آتَاكُمْ. When Allah gives you something, you're not elated. It does not affect your heart of dunya. When you lose something, you don't feel grief. That's a sign of iman. That's a sign that we've handed our matters to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of speaking about His greatness so much that His heart accepts. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ